All right, we're going to go back to the questions in a minute. This year, Homework Hotline has teamed up with the Golisano Foundation to bring you a new series called Move to Include. Throughout this series, we'll be learning about different intellectual and physical disabilities, and more importantly, how we can include people with disabilities, like me and you. All right, in this series, we're going to talk to and visit places that are doing just that. Tonight, we'd like to welcome Luticha back to the show. Hi, Luticha, how are you
Hi.
Doing again?
Welcome back.
Thanks for having me.
Cool. Thank you. The last time you were here, we talked about inclusion. Mm-hmm. Could you talk about this again? Could you refresh our memories about it, what it means to be inclusive?
So what it means to be inclusive is to make sure that everyone is just comfortable in the same space. So be welcoming, be kind, and be aware of each other and each other's boundaries.
All right. Okay. So now with your assistive device, how can someone address you sitting in a wheelchair? I mean, is it an uncomfortable situation for people to address you? I mean, we're sitting in chairs, which brings us down to your level, or down to this level, so we're sitting eye to eye instead of someone standing over you. So
it also really just depends on you. Like, I'm always going to be comfortable because okay. I'm sitting down in a comfy chair.
Sure.
So I really just defer to someone else and what they're comfortable with. If okay. you want to bend down, you can. You don't have to, you know. So I'm also very short, so it wouldn't matter anyway.
So now let's say someone had an iPad or a voice box that they're talking with. How would that make it any different, or would it make it any different?
So you just have a little bit of patience. Sometimes it takes a bit to input what they want to say.
Okay.
Or if someone is signing for someone, that's also very important to speak to the deaf person, not to the interpreter.
I always think so about that, too.
That's probably a mistake a
yes.
lot of people make.
That you want to watch the people doing the sign language
right.
instead of the expression that
right.
the person there.
And you don't say, well, can you tell them?
Right.
No, don't do that. You know, say, I have a question for you.
Right. Good.
Okay. That's okay. Patience is a key, and not being afraid to clarify questions, things like that. But I don't want to, and not jump to conclusions or assume that you know what they're talking about before they get everything out. But what if you don't really truly understand? Should you re-ask? Should you, how do you approach that? You don't want to hurt people's feelings.
Right, definitely always ask the person what they're comfortable with, what would you like, you know, just let me know. Always respecting people's boundaries. Know that it's not okay to touch someone's wheelchair without permission. This is an extension of our body. So just like you wouldn't touch someone else without asking permission first,
right.
it's always good to have consent for as far as that. Or if someone you think needs help, ask. And if they say no, be respectful and say, okay, thank you for letting me know.
Nice. Okay, so how has the weather for you been with a person in a wheelchair?
It's been horrible.
Has it?
Shut in my home, you know. It's hard to go out. It's hard when people don't shovel sidewalks very well,
right.
or if they just pile snow at the ends of the curb cuts. You know, I still need to be able to cross the street. Thank you for clearing the sidewalk, but how do I get across? So that's always mindful during the winter, is let people know that it's okay, you can shovel, and
sure.
that makes us feel included within the community and welcome in different spaces.
Good.
Yeah, I've noticed that some of the curb walks down have not been, and they actually have like 4 feet of snow in
right.
them. So what do you do? How do you?
Yeah, let's say you get to work.
I've seen people walking in the streets.
Right.
What do you do?
So usually when I get to work, I will call my coworkers and they will help me. There are several different assistive devices, but they're very expensive
sure.
and most people can't afford them.
So this doesn't have four-wheel drive then?
No, it doesn't have four-wheel drive. Darn, no off-roading.
Right. Well, cool.
Now, when you talk about assistive devices, you're talking about pretty much anything that helps somebody be part of, I don't know, the regular crowd, everybody else out there.
Right.
So like a hearing aid would be an assistive device.
Exactly, or a service dog. That service dog will open doors, pick up things for a person. They are considered an extension of yourself.
Nice.
Okay.
Very good.
All right, that's interesting.
Cool. Well, we want to thank you, Luticha, for coming on. It's been a pleasure again.
Thank you for having
Next
me.
Next time,
thank
we got to have you bring your bees and we can talk about those.
As that long as they're contained. I don't
they're
like
contained.
Bees.
Only in test tubes.
Okay.
That's good. Thank you.
You're welcome.
So, thank you very much for coming on, Anne.
For more information on Homework Hotline's Move to Include, go to website homeworkhotline.org and click on the Move to Include button on the homepage. And stay right there. We'll be back in a few seconds.